What we do is we plug in the USB in the back of the television and then we show him rhymes. We have converted his most watched Chota Bheem into English. Because what I feel, in fact, what we feel personally is like the English is the language which you are supposed to know. Even if I'm cooking, I am coming after from my work, I would, you know, sing that rhyme. He would train me ki, you know, Saloni say that's A, that's B, that's C. So he would just sit and watch and he would learn gradually. So audiovisual has always been one of the aids that, you know, makes the kid more.
We're starting to start using puzzles, jigsaw puzzles. We are giving him, okay, you need to put it here. So he's learning on those puzzles and all those things. That might help you increase in that.
We encourage him more to see things. I mean, when you, that's the human psychology. When you see things, you retain it more.
Apart from the usual activities that we have, you know, the puzzle sections at home, I mean, the cartoon time, drawing, coloring timings, and, you know, watching rhymes on the iPad or something. Other than that, we take up the initiative to help, so that she helps us in our daily course. So picking up a pile of, you know, not a very big pile, of course, of the folded clothes and keeping it there to a certain room or to a certain room, you know, sorting out things. Probably that helps her sorting and channelizing her energy into a much constructive way.
And then we try to, you know, give reasons to her for her reactions and actions, and try to relate her with things that she understands. Why we are asking her to do something, you know, when we reason it out and try to explain her, I think it's much better. The reasoning power and the grasp of the child becomes a little better.
There are times when she gets wild and she'll open up her cupboard, take out all her shoes and throw them here and there. And then you take time, what she wants, just try and understand, settle her down. And then 10 minutes later, please put all your shoes back. So that is work she has to do. So even if she does it 10 times in a day, she has to take up and keep it back.
I usually play a lot of puzzles games with her. So, numeric games and getting a lot of toys with her and getting acquainted with a lot of cartoons and all that, so that she...
We stimulate him to contribute. So we actually take him into decision making exercises as well. So, I mean, all in all, he's quite involved in, in entire these activities. He's also involved in deciding the menu. He's involved in where would we go for, you know, playing, which movie we'll go. So he's just 3.5, but he's part of everything.
Apart from schooling, there are things which are now available, especially, the games and applications on iPad. So before even she started learning alphabets, colors, shapes, you know, all these basic education elements, she was well versed with them because of the games available on iPad. So they were quite interactive, and she started developing her skills through that.
IQ levels, I think we have education, small games at home, maybe understanding a little of a small presentation, understanding colors or maybe shapes. That's at this level I can do.
We have a lot of games in the house. Like, for example, I hide something in somewhere and then I'm asking him to go and find it. So we'll give him hints. It could be here in this room, it could be here in this room. That's basically what we do with them.